Here are my top 10 favorite My Little Pony Friendship is Magic characters. Number 10, Flurry Heart. One of the cutest baby alicorn who will soon become the new ruler of the Crystal Empire. She may not have a lot of development for a baby, but I also like how determined she was in some scenes throughout the series. I would like to give her a belly rub and hear her tummy growl. Number 9, Starlight Glimmer. She's a good friend of Twilight and Trixie and it's a good idea to have her reformed. I like how she was first a counselor and then she became a head mare of the school. Despite her temper issues, I do like how she was able to solve her problems peacefully and try to get herself back on top. She usually hang out with Trixie mostly as they are both best friends. Even though I shipped Starlight with Sunburst, I would also maybe ship her with Trixie. I would also like her to perform some new magic as well. Number 8, Spike. He's a pretty cool dude. He saved the Crystal Empire, brought peace to the Chinglings, made friends with Ember and Thorax, and sprouted himself wings. In the future, he was bigger than he looked, even though one of his fantasy was a bit of a different design. He's very loyal to Twilight, which was ironic when Twilight told Spike that he is the new Rainbow Dash. I also shipped him with Rarity, since he loved her ever since. I also like the dog version of him when he went to the human world. Number 7, Ocelus. She is one of the shy one of the young six. I like her voice and she's mostly smart out of all of her friends. I like how she was able to change into different ponies and other living creatures as well. I wished we would have gotten more information about Ocelus, because it seems to me she didn't get as much spotlight as the rest of them. I would like to hear her stomach growl. Number 6, Discord. Discord is a pretty cool character. Despite him pretending to be Grogu'er, I still like how he was able to make some chaos magic. I do like his sinister voice and how he was reformed. I would also ship him with Fluttershy. I would also like to see him as a colt. Number 5, Scootle. One of the cutie mark crusader who helped get ponies their cutie mark. She is an excellent filly who ride on her scooter and try to look cool like Rainbow Dash. She also reminds me of Miles Tails Prower, because they both look up to their heroes and also acted like a sidekick to them. It's good that we were able to see Scooter's parents and not pretend she was actually an orphan. The only thing I would wish for her most is to have her fly, but I assume that she might not be able to. Her wings were still small when she got older, but it would be good that she can fly. Number 4, Sweetie Belle. Another one of the cutie mark crusader who helped get ponies their cutie mark. I love her singing, even though that wasn't truly her destiny. She is really good with magic, even for a filly. I sure wish she would be the leader of the cutie mark crusader and learn more about her. Number 3, Pinkie Pie. This sugar rush and hyper pony is always full of laughter. I love how she tells jokes and make treats for her friends. Her songs she sang is pretty good. My favorite would be that she was singing Giggle at the Ghosties and Smile. She even break the fourth wall, which is interesting that she might be one of those cartoon characters that does it. Number 2, Fluttershy. I love this shy pony. She is sometimes assertive in most cases as she usually come out of her shell. I like Fluttershy's mane and her voice. The best thing I like about her is her dark side that she had. Like trying to set a trap for the animals at the Grand Galloping Gala, becoming a vampire bat, and putting her hooves down after she took that advice from Iron Will. I would like to hear her stomach growl and I would also like to ride on her back. Number 1, Cozy Glow. I adore this sweet little filly. I also love her evil villainous rage toward the main six and also to her two companion Tyrek and Queen Chrysalis. She's smart enough to outsmart the main six, except when facing the young six. I just wish she didn't get turned into stone, but I would still want her to be a villain. It would have also been easier if she made her appearance in the first season so we can learn more about her. Furthermore, I would like to hear about her backstory of how she really became a villain. I also like to hear her stomach growl as well.